Artistry Plus is an amazing art channel. Please subscribe, like and share it. Thanks.
Rationality is a great con artist. Looks and feels like the right thing to do. For some though, irrationality is freedom. Freedom to think uninhibited human thought. In its truest form, uncouth and cringeworthy. This painting is a clash between the rational and irrational. This is a scene from a village. Something has happened. A car has fallen off a cliff. A group of villagers have gathered on the left to engulf in the catastrophe, to amuse themselves on a casual Tuesday afternoon. No concerns, no worry, just lots of giggling. Amitesh Srivastav, the artist of this work, told me that life in a small town of rural India is also something like that. Uninhibited, untamed and wild. Here being irrational does not mean being primitive. Progress is a blind man's game. Life in its liminal spaces has no rules. Nothing works here. Nothing. Some of you may see nothing really happening in this painting. Just a flurry of brushstrokes, rigorous, almost violent, full of rage and frustration perhaps. Come, look closer. You'll start seeing some curious events occurring. After a while, this painting will grow on you and you'll start to feel angry. Yeah. This painting is called Trespassers. The flurry of brushstrokes is actually a mesh of people trespassing on each other's space, not giving a f***. When the artist Amitesh shuts his eyes, his blurred vision and memory of his hometown looks kind of like this. It's not the usual memory you reminisce, but one that is latched onto you using rage and hopelessness. Like an unwanted shadow. Yeah, this painting is a rant, an anxiety attack on canvas. Look, on the left you can see the carcass of a dead animal, precariously sitting next to a bunch of people, almost alive as the caste system in India, engaging in conversation with you. The framework of being in this village is refreshingly authentic. It only looks exotic. And it doesn't care about your emotions. Let's get a little technical. This style of painting is called expressionism. Its typical trait is to present the world solely from a subjective perspective, distorting it radically for emotional effect in order to evoke moods and ideas. So, what emotions do you feel when you see this? And what do you think of when you think of nature? Lush green trees, rivers? I think of a sea of human beings. Because human nature is as raw as an untamed, unhinged forest. Forest sounds too nice here. Okay, let's say the wild, the jungle. In many ways, humanity is dangerous and wild, isn't it? Look at this. You see a white chaupal under a large tree for people to come and sit together, gossip, insinuate and hypothesize, throw enough shade on the town to put the whole tree to shame. Can you see these lovers? Yeah. They don't care about anything. They want to get out of here. What do you think? You think this woman feels safe here? Amitesh is angry about scenes from his village, where the air is different, cleaner yet dusty, simple yet wilder, more raw, absurd and irrational. Human nature, before anything else, is funny. Its purity is measured through the extent of absurdity, like units of absurd thoughts and acts, the irrational. Amitesh told me that a hipster young urban millennial would call his village crass and uncivilized. Poor fellow, city boy, believer of the system, asking himself over and over again, how should I be? I should be a caring citizen. I have value. I should care about the garbage and the animal carcass on the road, the well-being of others, the state of the nation and all that bullshit. Ha, look at you, having dreams of changing the system. That's cute. In this painting, the system is designed to fuck you over. It's devoid of social niceties. The irrational framework of being is currency. Politeness is an unruly alien. If you are polite, the people in this town will mock you. You better be like them, crass. matter of fact. The artist engages in the dangerous act of trying to make sense of this whole thing. He's ranting it all out. You can almost hear it. He has had enough of this town. It hasn't left him like a second skin. He is frustrated with its fine fabric, looking like it's made of intricate tradition, beauty, and raw Indian aesthetic. But it's actually made of shit, despair, hopelessness, and the absurd. Identity is a funny concept in this town. Everybody knows everybody, but nobody knows anyone. No wonder Amitesh is so cryptic in painting details. He knows everybody, but can't render them correctly. When together, the crowd merges into a blurry mush of humanity, watching, staring, peeling at your skin from a distance. They believe that the world gets a kick out of giving them pain. A bureaucrat, for example, finding pleasure in making a farmer wait outside his office for over 40 days, or stalling his documents for his own amusement, drafting policy after policy executed by individuals who cannot solve the problem, and honestly, don't even want to. As you watch this painting for longer and longer, the ranting and raging grows louder. There's no format to this rant. Formats are overrated. A joke in this town. So, again, what do you think of when you think of nature now? I see a pile of shit. Amitesh comes from a place like this and now lives in Bombay, but can't let go of something. Again, like an unwanted shadow. One conversation with Amitesh Srivastav and he'll explain everything wrong about the country. Again, rationality is a great con artist. You won't find it here. Please subscribe to Art History Plus. Please like, comment, and please share our videos. Thank you.